So, when you have completed the previous step, what you should get is here, as I said, you have the left foot, which is these two parts were grouped together, and also I have these three parts here grouped together. I have the rivet still, it's a single object there, and I have the same thing for the right, the leg of the right rivet, and also I have the robot. Okay, so this is the expected grouping that you will need. So now in this step, we need to create the joints. Okay, joints will be related with the servo axis because they will be motorized joints. So on each servo, we need to add a joint on the corresponding, obviously, direction. So this joint here, or this servo here, has a joint here, a vertical joint here, and that one has a horizontal one here. Also, these two servos there. Okay, but also we will have another joint here on the rivet, because this part will also rotate corresponding to a free axis based on this rivet here. Okay, so let's create, or let's show how to create a joint. This is something we can easily create here from the add menu joint. All of them will be revolute. Okay, so this is the joint. It's actually quite big, so let's modify the aspect. That's just simply an aspect, it's not that relevant. Okay, so let's put here 0, for instance, and 0.5, and we have a smaller joint there. Okay, and in this case, because I can change the dynamic properties of the joint, so in this case I want this joint to be the one attached to this servo here, so I need to enable the motor, and also because it's a position control servo, I need to enable the control loop, enable position control. Okay, the properties there. Okay, and for this joint I'm done. I can just simply rename it as left leg, for instance. Okay, and now the idea is to place this joint right there, and the problem is that any object has its own center or reference system, but it's not, in this case, this servo, the reference system is not indeed aligned to this vertical axis here. Okay, so what we need to do is to create an auxiliary object based on the actual axis of the servo. We can do that easily in the, if you follow the following instructions. So let's first move or visualize this component in this layer here, for instance. Okay, so let's invert that, and here it is. This is the component, the servo component, totally isolated. And let's create a new object based on part of the geometry of this servo here. So let's go to the toggle shape edit mode, and let's select only these triangles there and extract a cylinder. Now, this object that I have created, you will see it immediately, this one here. Okay, I will show it on this second layer there, and now this servo I can undo that. Okay, great. So this is the object I have created. Okay, and this object, and also let me just visualize here the joint I created. Here it is. Okay, so the idea is that I would like to move this joint here to the center of this new object here, temporary object. Okay, so I select the joint, I click on shift, and then I select the cylinder, and then I go for the position shift translation dialog, and then make sure you're in the position one, and then apply selection, and there you have it. The set, the joint has moved exactly to the same center as the auxiliary cylinder. Now we have that, we can just simply remove that. We don't need it anymore. Okay, and here we have indeed here we have indeed the servo joint that we have created here. Okay, we have to do the same thing here for this axis here. So this axis will be horizontal, so you will need to apply a rotation. And we will need to do that also for the axis we have here in the rivet. Indeed, this case is even easier because we already have a component, which is that one in that case, that we can use in order to place the corresponding axis. Okay? Make sure that this axis here, the ones related with the servo, have the motor enabled and control loop enabled properties checked. And the one here that you will need to create for the rivet, okay, or the ankle, will be without the motor because it's a free joint. Okay? Thank you very much.